A warm welcome to you all to this session. Today, in this video, I will be discussing about the inference lines for beams due to the combination of concentrated and moving loads. First, we have to know what is an inference line. It is a graph of a responses of a structure as a function of the position of a downward load moving across the structure. Why do we need the inference line? For instance, when load passes over a structure, say a bridge, one needs to know when the maximum value of the shear or reaction or bending moment will occur at a point so that the section may be designed. Moving live loads on a structure are of five types. They may also be a combination of distributed and concentrated loads. Such loadings involve tedious computations to determine the required stress components. A given system of loading across a girder or a structure can always be replaced by a uniformly distributed load longer than the span, such that the bending moment or shear force due to this static loading everywhere is at least equal to that caused by the actual system of moving loads. Such a static load is known as equivalent uniformly distributed load. This practice is often adapted in the specifications for railway loads in order to simplify analytical computations. In this video lecture, I am going to solve one problem with a combination of distributed and concentrated loads. Let's move on to the problem. So this is the problem. Four equal loads of 150 kN each, equally spaced at 2 meter apart, followed by a UDL of 60 kN per meter at a distance of 1.5 meter from the last 150 kN load, cross a girder of 20 meter span from right to left. Using the inference line, calculate the shear force and bending moment at a section 8 meter from the left hand support when the leading 150 kN load is at 5 meter from the left hand support. So, based upon the given data, first we have to place the load in a simply supported girder. The total length of the girder is 20 meter span. In this problem, I have highlighted the point right to left because the traverse of the load is from right to left. Okay. So, four equal loads are spaced at 2 meter apart, followed by a UDL, which is at a distance of 1.5 meter from the last 150 kN load. So, first we have to place the four equal loads and the UDL in the 20 meter span girder. Next thing, what we are the things we have to calculate? First, we have to calculate the shear force and bending moment both at the section of 8 meter from the left hand support. And also in the problem, they have mentioned the leading 150 kN. The leading 150 kN is at 5 meter from the left hand support. So then only we can place the load statically at the given beam of the span of girder 20 meter. Let's draw the sketch of the beam of 20 meter span. Here we can see the image of the girder of 20 meter span, and I have represented the section D, the D which represents the section 8 meter from the left hand support. So the green arrow represents the traverse of load is from right to left. Okay, so this is the load setup which is given in the problem. Let's solve the problem. First, they are asking to find out the maximum bending moment and shear force. So to find first Roman, to find maximum bending moment. The next thing, we have to find maximum shear force. So now I am first going to find out the maximum shear force. Maximum bending moment. So then the solution, Roman 1, maximum bending moment. So as given in the problem, I have placed the load and draw the influence line diagram. See, here we can see the image of the influence line diagram for maximum bending moment. In the problem, they have mentioned the length of the UDL, I mean this portion, the length of the UDL is 7.5 meter and the UDL is placed at 1.5 meter from the last 150 kN load and the leading of the load. The leading of the load represents the first 150 kN load. As I have already said, the load traverse is from left to right. Hence, the leading of the load will be this 150 kN load, which is at 5 meter from the left hand support. Is it? So, I have placed the load setup of 4 point loads and then UDL. Then, we have to draw the influence line diagram for the maximum bending moment. This is the ILD for maximum bending moment. Now, I am going to find out the ordinate at each load, under the load, which means first we have to find the ordinate at D. So, by keeping this as the benchmark, the ordinate at D, we have to find out the ordinate at this point E, and then F, and then G, and then H, and then I. Here I have shaded the portion because this shaded portion represents the area of the triangle. Here the uniformly distributed load is acting, so we have to shade this particular portion. Now I am going to find out the ordinate at D. So the next step is to find the ordinate at D. Ordinate at D, which is equal to, what is the formula to find out the maximum bending moment is x into L minus x by L. So x into L minus x whole divided by L, which is equal to, so the x represents the sectional distance. The distance between A and D is 8 meter as we can see in the image. So the value of x is 8 and the total length of the span is 20 minus, again the x value is 8, then close the bracket, whole divided by the total length of the span 20, which is equal to 4.8 meter. And then we have to find the ordinate under E. E means this point. Subsequently, we have to sequentially we have to find the ordinate at E, F, G, H and I. After that, we have to represent it in the influence line diagram. Next one, ordinate at ordinate at E, which is equal to 4.8 whole divided by 8 into 5. Which is equal to 3 meter. And then we have to find the ordinate at F. Next one is ordinate at F. Ordinate at F, which is equal to 4.8 whole divided by 8 into 7, which is equal to 4.2 meter. Next, ordinate under this point G, the ordinate under G, ordinate at G, which is equal to again 4.8 divided by 12 into 11, which is equal to 4.4 meter. Next thing, ordinate under the last point H, fourth point load, ordinate at H, which is equal to 4.8 divided by 12 into 7.5, which is equal to 3 meter. So now we have to represent those values in the inference line diagram. As you know, the ordinator E is 3, and then ordinate at F which is equal to 4.2, and then ordinate at D is 4.8, which is the maximum ordinate, and then ordinate at G is 4.4, and then ordinate at H is 3.6 meter, here it comes 3.6 meter. So the next one is ordinate at I is 3 meter. So now we are substitute those ordinate values in the inference line diagram. So the next thing we have to find out the maximum bending moment. So the maximum bending moment, the formula is load into the corresponding ordinate, but in case of UDL it is load into area. Let's find out bending moment, which means maximum bending moment, which is equal to load into ordinate load into this load into ordinate is for the first 4 point loads, and then plus load into area. This is for the UDL. So for the 150 kilonewton, which is equal to 150 into 3 plus again 150 into 4.2 and then plus 150 into the corresponding value is 4.4. Again, plus open bracket 150 into 3.6 plus the last UDL plus first thing, the intensity of the load is 60 into the area of the triangle is half into breadth into height. So 1 divided by 2 into the breadth of that particular portion is 7.5. into the ordinate of that particular portion is 3. So after calculation we will get the value as 2955 kilonewton meter. And then the second subdivision, we have to find out the shear force at this section. So the next subdivision is shear force. First we have to draw the inference line diagram for the particular shear force. So for both the positive and negative cases, here we can see the image of the, which means the ILD for the shear force. First we have to find the values of the ordinate at D for the maximum positive and ordinate at the same point for the maximum negative. So after calculating those values for positive and negative values, then we have to find out the ordinate under E, under F, under G, under H, and also under I. So after calculating the ordinates, then we have to find out the maximum shear force for the beam setup. So first one, we have to find the maximum positive ordinate. So what is the formula to find out the maximum positive ordinate? As we all know, L minus X by L. Maximum positive ordinate, which is equal to L minus X by L. L minus X whole divided by L, which is equal to the total length of the span is 20 minus the sectional distance is 8 whole divided by 20, which is equal to 0.6. Then maximum negative ordinate, which is equal to X by L, X whole divided by L, which is equal to X value is 8 divided by 20, which is equal to 0.4. So now we have to substitute that value in the ILD of the shear force. So the maximum positive value is 0.6 and then the maximum negative value is 0.4. Now keeping this as a benchmark, you have to find out the ordinate at F, E, G, H and I. As I said earlier, next we have to find the ordinate at those points. So the next thing, ordinate under E. Which is equal to, here we can see the ordinate under E comes in the portion of negative shear force. So here we have to represent the minus symbol. So minus 0.4 divided by 8 into 5, which is equal to minus 0.25. Next thing, ordinate under F. Ordinate under F is equal to, F is also comes under the negative portion, so we have to represent the negative sign, minus 0.4 divided by 8 into 7, which is equal to minus 0.35. Now we have to go for the positive side. First one is ordinate under G. Which is equal to 0.6 whole divided by 12 into 11, which is equal to 0.55. Next, ordinate under H. Ordinate under H, which is equal to 0.6 divided by 12 into 9, which is equal to 0.45. Then last, ordinate under I. Which is equal to 0.6 divided by 12 into 7.5, which is equal to 0.38. Now we have to substitute those values in this diagram. So ordinate under E, is 0.25. The next thing is ordinate under F. Ordinate under F is 0.35. The next thing is ordinate under G. The ordinate under G is 0.55. And then ordinate under H. Ordinate under H is 0.45. And then ordinate under I, the value, corresponding value is 0.38. So this zone represents positive and this zone represents negative. So here we have to represent that positive and negative, and here it is negative. Here we have to represent the diagram mean. It is ILD for shear force. So we have found out the ordinate and we have drawn the influence line diagram. Now we have to find out the maximum shear force. So maximum shear force is, which is equal to load into ordinate for the point loads and load into area for the other loads. So maximum, last step, maximum shear force, which is equal to the first load is 150. So 150 into corresponding value is minus 0.25. So 150 into minus 0.25, close the bracket, plus again second load 150 into minus 0.35, close the bracket, plus again the third load 150 into the corresponding value is 0.55. Close the bracket. Again, the fourth load is 150 into 0.45. Again, close the bracket. Then the UDL. So it is the shaded portion which represents the area of the triangle. So the intensity of the load is 60. So 60 into off into breadth into height. The breadth is 7.5, and then the height is 0.38. Then close the bracket. So after the substitution, we will get the maximum shear force as 145.5 kilonewton. So this is the procedure to find out when there is a combination of both point load and uniformly distributed load in a simply supported beam. It is a statically determinate beam. Hope you all understand how to find out the maximum bending moment and shear force using the inference line diagram. Thank you all for your pleasant listening. Thank you so much.